And the way I used it on my particular hair caused some issues for me. Yeah.
Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Rice water ruined my hair. Not exactly, but I couldn't help it. I had to take a dig at all the hair ruination videos we've been seeing lately. But that is a whole other topic that I will get back to in my year-end roast. I think I'm finally gonna do one, so look out for that. But in the meantime, let's get back to this rice water. And I'm going to responsibly state that something didn't quite work for me. Rice water didn't ruin my hair, but it did create some difficulties for me, which we'll talk about right now. But first, let's go back to the beginning, why I wanted to try it, what I did, how it worked, everything. Just for your information and entertainment, I guess, right now. So like all of you, I'm a member of the natural hair community on social media, which means I heard all the buzz about rice water maybe 6 months ago, a year ago. I don't know how long it's been being talked about. I guess ever since Vicks. Rice water was right after Vicks. So, you know, it's been a while. I was curious. People were talking about like toe-length hair, like Japanese and Chinese women who had like really long hair using rice water. People were saying that they were getting really great definition and the hair was growing so fast and all that, and it was just amazing and everybody wanted to try it. So for me personally, I don't really care about growth. I don't really care about curl definition, but the claim was it acted like a protein treatment, one of the claims. So I was thinking that this would be a nice DIY strengthening treatment that I can do every now and then instead of doing a protein treatment, and I wanted to try it out to see how it worked for me. Some of the claims were that, of course, it grew your hair, it reduced hair breakage, it helped control dandruff, it helped fight the effects of hard water by introducing magnesium, which helps to get rid of like extra calcium. Some said it even delayed gray hair, like graying. What else? It helped to increase blood circulation to the scalp. It was just doing everything. Doing everything, you know. The main part that I found interesting was that rice water contains inositol, which is supposed to penetrate the strand and help to strengthen the strand, similar to like a protein treatment, and also stay in the strand after washing or after a few washes, just like a protein treatment. So that's why I was interested, because I was like, okay, a nice easy DIY protein treatment sounds interesting. Plus, hey, if it wants to do all the other things like stimulate my scalp, and it's supposed to even like reduce stress, girl, it was doing everything. Hundreds of people were saying it was so amazing. So I was like, okay, well, you know, give it a try. It took me like 6 months or something, pretty much from when I heard about it to like 2 months ago, to actually try it, because I'm lazy and I don't wash on schedule and stuff like that. But I found out from someone else that you can just make it and refrigerate it. So I was like, okay, that's a little more doable for me than making it and hoping that I happen to wash when I think I'm gonna wash. So I made it. I'm gonna show you how I made it. And within like a day or two, I used it. And I'll show you how I used it. So everything was going fine the first week, and I was like, let me use it for like a month straight so I'm gonna know how it really does and like if it's really working and stuff. I didn't even make it to the month, let me just tell you that. The first time I did it, like I shampooed my hair and I tried to spray it on. Eventually I just like dunked it on, left it on for 20 minutes, rinsed it out, and then deep conditioned. So the first thing I noticed, my hair did seem softer, smoother, definitely was easier to detangle, which was kind of weird because it didn't have slip in itself, but after I put my product and I was like detangling, finger detangling through or raking through, it was definitely like much easier to detangle, like much easier to rake my hands through. So I'll definitely say that for it, like if you're doing any kind of manipulation, if you've done your rice water treatment before, it's a lot easier. The cuticles did seem even lower, remember that. the cuticles did seem even like smoother, and it did seem easier to rake once I added product with slip. So I was kind of like, you know, I'm not seeing any amazing immediate wow, but it did seem a little better, so let me keep going. The second week I did the same thing, mixed up my rice water. This time I think I just dumped it on and then immediately put my conditioner over it. So it basically sat for the 20 minutes with my conditioner. Same thing, my hair felt smoother. It was easier to detangle. But then I noticed that my hair seemed a little bit drier during the week. So I was like, like my hair doesn't get dry during the week. Like it really doesn't get dry during the week. So I'm like, okay. I think I had used some Eco Styler that week. So I was like, okay, maybe it's the products. Next week I'm gonna use like a tried and true or something like that. So the next week, I did it again. This time my hair actually even felt a little bit hard. So on top of like losing moisture and losing definition, like usually my wash and goes always last a week. Midweek my hair was kind of dry, it was frizzy, so I was like, what's going on? Like, this never happens to me. Even in some of my videos you can see that water was just like rolling off my hair and nothing was penetrating, so it was just not letting anything in. So that was kind of scary to watch. I was like, okay, that's it for this experiment. I'm not even gonna make it to a fourth week. I just abandoned ship. So it's only been about a week or two since I stopped, but already my hair is doing better, like feeling more moisturized and getting a little bit of definition back and everything. So I think it's great for high porosity. I think it's great for normal porosity. Hey, it may even be good if you have hard water maybe, but for my ultra low porosity, for my hair, it really just wasn't doing what it was doing for everybody else. I would say if you have low porosity, definitely be cautious, because I feel like it smooths your cuticle even more and seals off your strand even more, so it was even harder to get moisture in. And if you overdo it, like do it too often, I feel like that it can kind of build up in your hair and just not allow as much water to penetrate your strand. So I do think I want to try it again, but not every week. I think the every week part was what killed it for me. So I've been seeing people using it every week. I've been seeing people even leaving it in, like using it as a leave-in and just leaving it in there and having great results. But for my wiry low porosity hair, like that was just too much for me. So I want to get my hair back on track, like back to its usual moisturized self and its usual level of definition. And then I do want to use it maybe once a month as a strengthening treatment. I'm not going to say protein treatment because I'm not sure if it's the protein or the inositol that's really having the strengthening effect. I couldn't see any research that said that the actual protein in the rice water was hydrolyzed or was small enough to penetrate your strand. But I know I read that the inositol does penetrate your strand and does act similar to protein in terms of strengthening the strand. So I'll probably still do like my Curl Origin protein treatment and stuff now and again as well. But I do think it'll be a good thing to add to my regimen, just not that often. So I'll keep you guys posted on my rice water progress, but as of right now, at least weekly rice water is a no for me, and I'm gonna be using it with caution, get my moisture back, then try using it maybe once a month or something. But yeah, that was my experience. Let me know how rice water worked for you. I know a lot of people love it and most people love it. I only see like a few people who said it was a no for them, so let me know if you experienced anything I experienced or just if you loved it. So I hope this was fun, I hope this was informative. Let's chat in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.